Let's put up the picture. Disabled woman was waiting for 95 minutes, 95 minutes at the airport to be assisted to get off of British Airways. And they got her 95 minutes later. Let's play the video of her interview.
And it was just very frustrating, very demeaning.
Well, I was just going to ask you that. It must feel humiliating. Everybody else is off the plane. It's just you that's left. And the minutes tick by, nobody comes, and there you are, completely stranded. It must be humiliating.
Yeah, and I'd booked the support 2 months in advance. So it wasn't as if they weren't expecting me. They knew I was coming. And it wasn't just me that was affected. The plane could not take off until I was off the plane. And so the next flight was delayed. So all the passengers who were supposed to be on the next flight, they were delayed by an hour and a half as well.
So you're frustrated for yourself, but you can also, I'm sure, empathise with the frustration of the other people who want to get on and get off on a holiday.
And so improving the service for disabled people is important because it improves service for everybody.
Yeah.
This is so damn sad. Put up a picture. Her name is Victoria Brignell, okay? Victoria is a remarkable person. She's paralyzed from the neck down, uses a wheelchair. While aware it would be a wait to get off the plane, Victoria was instead left stranded after the airport staff failed to assist her. Following the incident, this young lady, Victoria, is now calling for the aviation sector to change and redesign the planes that cater to wheelchair users. This was only the second flight she had been on and had been put off by flying due to the horror stories from other wheelchair users. Victoria explained to Insider that when a plane lands, she needs to be lifted from her plane seat into an aisle chair, a specialist wheelchair used to transport wheelchair users to the door of the plane and then transferred into their wheelchairs. Victoria said, and I quote, "The crew told me that it would take 50 minutes for staff to come to get off the plane later. I was then told I would be another half an hour on top. The airline staff were wonderful. They kept asking me if I was okay. They were offering me drinks and they wouldn't stop apologizing even when it wasn't their fault. In the frustrating 95 minutes, Victoria was stuck in an uncomfortable position, propped up by cushions to support her body and without a bathroom to use. The commercial airlines do not have accessible toilets. Eventually, Victoria and the British Airways staff gave up waiting and the crew helped her off the plane." Let's show a picture of her and her friend. Okay, his name is Kevin, all right? So Victoria was accompanied on the flight with her friend, and this person is upset, all right? So Kevin was enjoying a holiday with his dear friend. Kevin said, and I quote, "Leaving disabled passengers stranded is shameful. He was shocked when they were first told to wait at least 50 minutes for assistance." He added further, "The excuse given to staff was about shortages in staff was unacceptable and backup plans should have been in place." I completely agree. Gatwick Airport has since apologized for the incident. A spokesperson told Inside, and I quote, "The treatment received at the airport was unacceptable. Our chief executive and chief operating officer have both spoken to and offered their sincere apologies to Victoria." But this is not isolated. Let's put up the picture of Daryl, okay? That's Daryl. Daryl was left on the flight for 2 hours at Manchester Airport and eventually had to call the police in order to be assisted off the plane. Now, let me tell you why I highlight this. We talk a lot about diversity in this country, and typically what we're talking about, what we mean by that reference is racial and cultural diversity, sometimes even religious diversity. But you can't really talk about diversity without including our disabled brothers and sisters. You cannot talk about diversity authentically without including how this world has not transformed enough to accommodate them. Well, we will talk about that. It is shameful that this airline receives millions of dollars from consumers and they have no actual design protocol to make sure that they are able to serve everybody. So this is a systemic issue that must be addressed in a systemic way. If we do not change the actual policy of these particular companies, this will happen over and over again. So that's why we bring it to your attention. All right, Sharon, thoughts here.
I think the airline industry has to start by telling the truth, Rashad.
Yeah.
And the truth is, they should put today on every ticket, you know, before you press and you pay that final step, air travel is for the able-bodied only, because that's the truth. This is disgusting. I actually feel guilty because, you know, before I dug into the story, I was remembering a time where I was stuck on the tarmac for 4 hours at LaGuardia. I can't get that time back. I felt like I was being held hostage. Imagine how she felt. The first thing I do is I reach up and I make sure the air's on and I'm fine and everything's cool. She didn't even probably have, I understand the crew was wonderful, God bless them for finally getting her off of there, but she probably didn't even have any more of those little snack packs. You know, ones that only have about 3 peanuts in them. This whole thing is disgusting and it's correctable. It's so easy to fix this. They don't care. Put the disclaimer on the tickets today.
Yeah, and here's another thing we can do. Until all airlines, and I don't care where you travel from, we got people that watch this show in Australia, UK, everywhere. You boycott airlines that treat our disabled brothers and sisters in such an egregious manner. Mm-hmm. And I guarantee you, you will see a policy transformation immediately, all right? I plan to follow up because there are other instances and complaints that are connected to this story. They have not been fully investigated in journalism, but we're gonna do that. And I'll bring you an update to the story.